Hello, I'm Adam and welcome. Today we'll talk about pretty interesting 3D printer motherboard which I bought for about $20, and it's 32-bit running SmoothieWare, which is really great. And quick question, do you need 32 bits in your 3D printer?
Yes.
Especially for the customization which allows SmoothieWare in ease of use a config file, because you don't have to compile your Arduino, Sketch, and you only edit the text file and reload a 3D printer and that's it. Restart a 3D printer and that's it. So, yes, if you are planning to upgrade board, just look for the 32 bits board, because it's now really cheap and it's really, really better than 8 bits. Okay, so I've got this box, SKR 1.3. I know there is a 1.4 version which is better, even there is 1.4 turbo version, but I bought this board just few days after they announced 1.4 board. So anyway, there is not much big difference. So we'll take a look what's inside this box. We've got a cable, we've got a board, and that's it. And oops, I need something sharp. Okay, and there is a board with the jumpers. So let's start from the corner. There is 12 volt output or 24 volts, because the board can, wow, that's so nice. Yeah, as you can see, there is everything described. That's really great, and the PCB is pretty nice done. It's black and okay. Anyway, yeah, but yeah, that's a Chinese board. Don't forget about that. So there is a 12 volt header output. If you want to have a stable 12 volts directly from your PSU, always on. There are headers for the motors, and as I can see, there is a XYZ, and the Z is not doubled, for example, in Hypercube to Z motors. So we will have to buy a separate splitter, but in 1.4 there is a double Z, so that's what improved. Extruder, that's okay. We've got, there is something, okay. There we've got five headers for the step sticks, which is really great, because we can put there any step sticks we want, and there is nothing soldered. What's more, we can control or configure step stick through UART or the SPI. I'm talking about the TMC step sticks. So that's great. Next, we've got two headers for the standard LCD. Those are end stops. Next, we've got thermistors for the heated bed, for the second extruder, for the first extruder, AUX panel, where we've got 5 volts, ground, and UART pins. It might be useful for the upper pins. Those upper pins are useful for the additional TFT LCD. And we've got a SD card, even with board, 128 megabytes. That's enough, because this SD card will have only config file, which weighs few kilobytes and that's it. Okay, there is a USB-B port, I hide them. But, wow, even the USB pins are described, that's really nice. And we've got fuses, and they are standard like in your car. That's good because Chinese boards have really awful fuses. And now the headers for the input and the heat bed, hot end and second hot end or fan. I must tell you that it's better quality than I've got on the RAMPS board, because on the RAMPS I have always resoldered them and replaced. I had to replace them and put a little bit stronger, bigger. And yeah, so there is a really important thing, and this int or 5 volts I have same on the rearm board, and this jumper determines source of your board power. That means if it switched to the USB, it will be powered only from the USB port, for example, which is connected to your server. And you should use it in this case if you are going to turn off or turn on your power supply. Because if you are will be powered from the power supply and you will turn it off, you won't be able to turn it on because the board will be powered off. Yeah, so if you want to control your power supply through the board, just make sure you have connected it to the USB port and the board is powering from the USB port. That means if you turn off the power supply will turn off, but the board will stay alive. I can show you which MOSFETs are used. And yeah. So, and which processor, but that won't matter. And maybe close up. Okay. And that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Please leave a comment and hit the subscribe button. Bye.